All right, hello everyone, and welcome to Asia. All right, guys, we've been following this trade idea from resettlement. I was hoping that price would trade through this BISI and come hit our sell side targets. It did not do that. We're trading back up into our prior BISI, and I'm looking to get short a third contract here at ICT bearish order block. And then I'm looking for price to come redeliver this lower BISI and lower liquidity targets. The Tokyo Stock Exchange just opened. We're at 25% of this BISI, at which price could react. And that would be fine. Two contracts is fine. Guys, this recording is going to go on for maybe an hour and a half. Okay, so this is going to be Asian session part one. Guys, YouTube comment policy. If you comment, I'm giving you a canned response. Not because I hate you, but because it's just a waste of time for me to answer you in the comment box. Most of you ask the same things. So, like, I'm a novice, what do I do? Model 2022 playlist. Do I use any indicators, VWAP, whatever? The answer is no. Clearly, I do not. Any particularly interesting comments, and most of them are not. I will answer in a video like this, and you will actually have to watch. I know what most of you do. You'll watch it for about 5 minutes, scroll through it, and then, you know, you won't actually give me the watch time, and I need watch time. So it's kind of a balancing act for me, right? I want to please you, but I need to, you know, get watch time. I need work. So if you really... I will try to answer comments, but it's going to be in the video, and you will have to watch. You might not like that, and that's okay. If you dislike the video, that is also interaction to the YouTube algorithm, so that's okay as well. You can go ahead and dislike. I do appreciate that as well. But yeah, I'm starting to get a lot of YouTube comments kind of like all the time. And if I actually, you know, spend time answering all of them, I'm wasting time studying, I'm wasting time trading, learning. So it's really not in my interest. So you are going to get a canned response. Sorry. If you don't know what a canned response means, if you've ever done like customer service, it's like your generic, you know, go away response. I'm not doing that to be rude to you. I have to focus. It's kind of like having book map up and hearing it go, iceberg order. I mean, that's, come on. Talk about something distracting. Iceberg order. Hey, that's an iceberg order. So, you know, YouTube commenters, I do appreciate it, but I will respond to you in videos, and you will have to watch. I need watch time. You want to learn. Kind of a value proposition thing, right? Okay, guys, we are in Asia. I'm going to step away for a minute. Здравствуйте, моим товарищам. Здравствуй. Привет всем. Я вернусь. Я сейчас с вами. Так что. We're watching. We're waiting. Guys, good reaction here off of this old BISI up here. We're trying to, we got a close below the BISI in which we're currently working. We created an inefficiency here, a SIBI that price is currently redelivering. I would like to see that now act as resistance and for price to start its journey lower. That would be kind of the ideal scenario. That being said, we're coming back up to ICT, bearish order block here. Would like to see price stay below the midpoint of that, ideally. Welcome to Asia. Okay, so ICT bearish order block would be here, and I would like price to stay below the midpoint of that. This would be low, high, low, so this would be ICT bearish breaker as well. You can see that price is working within this old BISI right here. See that? We're working within that BISI right here. Okay, guys, that order right there, the idea behind that, the new order, is that if price travels below the BISI in which we're currently operating, if we come back below it again, you showed us, так что price должен продолжаться падать, если price будет идти еще пониже, то да. Так что. Give me love, baby, give me love now, yeah. Okay, I'm going to put in some risk mitigation here, guys. So we are currently short 2. $190.5. I want to see price get above the midpoint of that order block. And if it does, then we're going to be stopped out. That's kind of the current thinking. Actually, I'll just put it above that high. So 195, 190, what is that? 195 evens. Okay, I don't want to see price get above that high. And if it does, we're going to be stopped out. And we'll have to reassess from there. So that's going to be our risk mitigation there. We're now working in ICT bearish order block, which would be right there. I don't want to see price get above that high, and if it does, we are going to be stopped out, and we will reassess from there. So that's my risk mitigation. All right, we'll see. We're working in ICT bearish order block right now. And then above this would be ICT rejection block. Okay, we're probably going to be stopped out on this one. And then we will reassess. This would be a good place for price to turn around, I think. ICT rejection block, ICT bearish order block, but we could work up into that prior BISI as well. All right, it does look like we're going to be stopped out on this one. I thought the price was going to make its journey down to this liquidity and to that inefficiency right now. Looks like my timing might be a bit off. So. Just going to allow the marketplace to stop me out and then we'll work from there. All right. Unfortunately, we started the day off at a loss. I will show you those executions. I got short here and I got short here, thinking we would draw down into this BISI and this liquidity, which I do think we are going to end up doing. But I didn't really want to see it go above that high, so now I'm going to wait. I'll wait and see. If we turtle soup this high, go back down to a 3 minute, 1 minute. If we turtle soup that high there, start turning back lower immediately, then I'll put the shorts back on. That immediate sell-off reaction would tell me that this is going to turtle soup. But we will see. 5 minute, the next short is going to come on right there, if we get there. Okay, that's ICT bearish order block, the low of that candle. So it's drawing up into this same BISI that it's been working, drawing up to this buy side liquidity. So it wants to go all the way up. Second short would come on at rejection block. All right, so we took a loss. That's looking like it's going to turtle soup. So we're going to have one short on and see where we go from there. I have one short on, turtle soup pattern of that high. So, and it also three drives, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we've had an unseen. You see how price immediately shot lower after getting above that high? That's looking very turtle soupy, but I didn't know that that was going to turtle soup before it did it. So I'd rather be stopped out. Okay, so do y'all see how it came above that high and immediately rejected it? That's kind of a turtle soup signature. So I don't expect that price should go much higher now. In fact, how you play turtle soups, or you're supposed to play them, is my stop should go right there. But I'm not going to do that. Okay. Second contractor come on there. Might work its work its way into a small premium relative to this BISI. And third contract would come on if price comes below and makes this a bullish order block, sorry, bearish order block. So I'm waiting to see what the market's doing now. We're short one, looking at the market's initial reaction on making a new high here. You know, considering the reason why I have that sell limit up there is that considering that we're just turtle souping every new high, I'm assuming that the next high will also be turtle souped as well. If we get there. All right, I'll be back, guys. I'll be back. Hi. I did not mean to. Well, whatever. We're short three. All right. And the stop is going to go above that high. So I don't want to see it get above the high that we just made. So that would be 196 quarters. So we're following the same idea that it should come back down and redeliver this BISI down here and attack this sell side liquidity. We're short three. I will add on more, you know, as we go down. That's a turtle soup pattern. Or three drives pattern. One drive, two drive, three drive. It's generating that buy side liquidity, going to trap traders short. Sorry, yeah, long. Going to trap them long to plunge lower. But I don't know when that plunge is going to happen. So with turtle soup patterns, what he teaches is that you're going to be repeatedly stopped out, which sucks. But it is what it is. If you're trading turtle soups, you're gonna be stopped out repeatedly. Because you don't know exactly which high they're going to turtle soup before it happens. It's difficult to know. So, okay, executions. You can see that first contract here came on there, second contract came on there, third contract came on there. At some point in the near-ish future, I expect that price will plunge lower, about 20, or what is this, 30 to 50 points. So, kind of the expectation. At some point. Exactly when? I don't know.
Exactly when? I do not know.
We have to be repeatedly stopped out before we get it, that's fine. Because that's a turtle soup pattern. One of these will be the high before they plunge it. All right. All right, we're going to stop the recording there. We're probably going to be stopped out again and have to wait for another turtle soup pattern, which is frustrating, but it is what it is, guys. We're playing turtle soups here. I'm expecting a 30 to 50 point plunge some point. When it wants to do that, I don't know. All right, I'm going to stop the recording there, guys. This is Asia Part 1.